Today's topic of discussion is nucleic acids. Let us first discuss about the historic resume of the nucleic acids. So in 1869, Frederick Mischer was the first person who isolated the nucleic acid, and he called it as a nucleon. He isolated it from the nuclei of the blood cells. Nuclei were shown to have the acidic properties, hence it was called as nucleic acid. Now let us know in detail about the nucleic acid. Nucleic acids are the polymers that consist of the nucleotide residues. These are located in the nuclei of the cell. These are nothing but the hereditary determinants of the living organisms. So what is elemental composition of the nucleic acid? Nucleic acid contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, and phosphorus. So what are the types of nucleic acids? There are two types of nucleic acids. They are deoxyribonucleic acid and ribonucleic acid. In short, they are called as DNA and RNA. Now let us know about the distribution of nucleic acids in the eukaryotic cell. DNA is mainly found in the nucleus, with small amounts presenting in the mitochondria and chloroplast. RNA is found throughout the cell. Now let us know about the nucleic acid structure. Nucleic acids are nothing but the polynucleotides. Their building blocks are nucleotides. So what are nucleotides? Nucleotides are the energy-rich compounds that drive the metabolic process in the cell. They serve as a chemical signals, and they also serve as a key links in the cellular systems that respond to the hormones and other extracellular stimuli. Each nucleotide is formed by three units, phosphate group, sugar, and nitrogenous base. So let us discuss about the nucleotide structure in detail. Nucleotide has a phosphate group, sugar, and a base. Under sugar, we have deoxyribose sugar or ribose sugar. Under base, we have a purines or pyrimidines. In purines, we have adenine and guanine. In pyrimidines, we have cytosine, thymine, and uracil. So nucleotide is made of phosphate group, sugar group, and a base. So now let us discuss about the phosphate group of the nucleotide structure. So first is a phosphate group. Phosphate is in the form of phosphoric acid. Molecular formula is H3PO4. It contains three monovalent hydroxyl group and a divalent oxygen atom. All are linked to the pentavalent phosphorus atom. So this was all about the phosphate group of the nucleotide structure. Now coming to the sugar group of the nucleotide, it exists as 5-carbon keto sugar or pentose group. One possesses D2 deoxyribose and the other contains the D-ribose. So both sugars are present in furanose form and beta configuration. So both deoxyribose and the ribose exist as furanose form and beta configuration. So this sugar molecule, which is called as pentose sugar, forms the esters with the phosphoric acid, which we have discussed earlier. So this sugar is forming the esters with the phosphoric acid, and finally it is forming phosphodiester bond. Coming to the final component of the nucleotide structure, that is called as base. Base is nothing but the nitrogenous base here. There are two types of nitrogenous base. They are purines and pyrimidines. So this base is linked to the sugar moiety by the same carbon used in the sugar-sugar bond. Purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are uracil, thymine, and cytosine. Till now we have studied about the nucleotide structure in detail. Now let us know about the nucleoside. When ribose or 2-deoxyribose is combined with the purine or pyrimidine base, nucleoside is formed. So in nucleoside, the sugar molecule binds to the purine base. So only the sugar and the base is present. Phosphate group is absent. This is a major difference between the nucleotides and the nucleoside. In nucleotide, phosphate, sugar, and base is present. Whereas in nucleoside, only the sugar and the base is present. Phosphate group is absent. Now let us know about the backbone of the nucleic acid. That is a sugar phosphate backbone. The nucleotides here are all oriented in the same direction, and the phosphate group joins the third carbon of one sugar to the fifth carbon of the next in line. So one phosphate group is joining the third carbon of one sugar and the fifth carbon of the next sugar molecule. Now adding in of the bases. The bases are attached to the first carbon. Their order is important. It determines the genetic information of the molecule. So remember that the bases are attached to the first carbon. So now talking about deoxyribonucleic acid in detail, every living organism contains DNA. It is nothing but the material of inheritance. It is discovered in 1960. It is discovered by Franklin, Watson and Crick. Through series of experiments, it is concluded that DNA is the genetic material present in the nucleus of the cell. So DNA is present in the nucleus of the cell. Human DNA contains 3 million deoxyribonucleotide residues and contains 25,000 genes. Genes are stretch of DNA that carries codes of protein production. So here is the structure of DNA. DNA is made of two strands of polynucleotides. These are the hydrogen bonds which are binding the two strands. So DNA is made of two strands of polynucleotides. The sister strands of the DNA molecule run in the opposite directions. That means anti-parallel. The two strands which are opposite to each other, they are in anti-parallel direction. They are joined by the bases. Each base is paired with a specific partner. A is always paired with the T. G is always paired with the C. Please remember A, T, G, C. A is paired with T. G is paired with C. That is, each purine is paired with a pyrimidine. Thus, the sister strands are complementary but not identical. The bases are joined by hydrogen bonds. Now, talking about the purines and pyrimidines, as we have already known, that purines and pyrimidines are nothing but the nitrogenous bases. So, here the purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are thymine and cytosine. So please remember there are two purines, adenine and guanine. Apart from that, thymine and cytosine are the pyrimidines. Now coming to the structure of DNA, DNA has double helical structure. So this double helix model was discovered in 1953. So the structure of DNA can be understood in terms of three levels of the structure: primary, secondary and tertiary. So the primary structure refers to the sequence of its nucleotide residue. Secondary structure, it pertains to the helix formed by the two DNA strands. Tertiary structure refers to the three-dimensional shape which arises from the supercoiling where double helix is being twisted into a compact shape. Now let us know about very important topic, DNA replication. DNA carries all the information necessary for making the protein required by the living organisms. To pass the information stored in the DNA to new generation of the cell, DNA replication must take place. This information is carried in the primary structure of the DNA. When DNA is replicated, each strand of the double helix serves as a template for the manufacture of a new strand of the DNA. So for the manufacture of the new strand of the DNA, DNA replication is mandatory. So we need to know that new strands of DNA are forming from the DNA replication itself. So as we know, DNA has two strands. So each and every strand is acting as a template for the manufacture of a new strand of DNA. In each of the daughter DNA strands, one strand from the parent DNA is present. This is called as semi-conservative replication. The production of the new DNA is carried out by the enzymes called as DNA polymerases. So the enzymes working here are DNA polymerases. DNA polymerase catalyzes the addition of the deoxyribonucleotide residues to a growing DNA strand. Same here, let us study about the DNA replication in a pictorial form for better understanding. Here, this is the parent molecule. The parent molecule has two complementary strands of the DNA. Each base is paired by the hydrogen bonding with a specific partner. A is with T, G is with C. So the first step is the replication. Replication is the separation of two DNA strands. So these double helical structure is getting separated first. So each parental strand now serves as a template. So this strand is serving as a template. So for this AT is formed, for this CG is formed. So each parental strand now serves as a template that determines the order of the nucleotides along a new complementary strand. So firstly, the DNA strands separate from each other, and each parental strand of the DNA forms the new DNA strand opposite to it. So the nucleotides are connected to form the sugar phosphate backbones of the new strands. Each daughter DNA molecule consists of one parental strand and one new strand. That was all about the DNA, DNA structure and DNA replication. Now let us study about RNA. RNA is nothing but ribonucleic acid. Like DNA, it is a long unbranched macromolecule consisting of the nucleotides joined by 3' to 5' phosphodiester bonds. The number of ribonucleotides in RNA ranges from as few as 75 to many thousands. Now coming to the structure of RNA. RNA structure is similar to that of DNA. Both contain a sugar phosphate polymers and both have nitrogen containing bases. But apart from these, there are three differences between them. RNA contains a different monosaccharide residue, and also RNA contains the bases A, G, C and U instead of A, G, C, T. In case of DNA, we have adenine, guanine, cytosine, thymine. In case of RNA, we have adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. So A, G, C are similar, but only U and T are different. So in case of RNA, we have uracil. In case of DNA, we have thymine. So RNA also exists as a single strand instead of a double strand. This is how RNA differs from the DNA. So this is the structure of RNA. This is the helix of a sugar phosphate. These are the nucleotide base pairs. This is cytosine. This is guanine. This is adenine. And this is uracil. All these are the nucleobases of the RNA. Now let us know about the types of RNA and their functions. There are messenger RNA, heterogeneous nuclear RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomal RNA, small nuclear, small nucleolar, small cytoplasmic and transfer messenger RNA. So let us discuss about each and every one in detail. Messenger RNA, also called as mRNA, it transfers the genetic information from genes to the ribosomes to synthesize the proteins. So mRNA is responsible for transferring the genetic information from the genes to the ribosomes. Next is heterogeneous nuclear RNA, also called as hnRNA. It serves as precursor for mRNA and other RNAs. Next is transfer RNA, also called as tRNA. It transfers the amino acids to the mRNA for protein synthesis. Next is ribosomal RNA, also called as rRNA. It provides the structural framework for ribosomes. Next is small nuclear RNA, also called as snRNA. It is involved in mRNA processing. Next is small nucleolar RNA, also called as snoRNA. It plays a key role in processing of rRNA molecules. Next is small cytoplasmic RNA, also called as scRNA. It is involved in the selection of proteins for the export. Next is transfer messenger RNA, also called as tmRNA. It is mostly present in bacteria and adds the short peptide tags to the proteins to facilitate the degradation of the incorrectly synthesized proteins. Next, coming to the nucleic acid and protein synthesis. The following three processes are involved in the duplication, transfer and use of the genetic information. They are replication, transcription and translation. So first is replication. It is a process by which a replica or the identical copy of DNA is made when a cell divides. Then next is transcription. It is a process by which the genetic messages contained in the DNA are read and copied. Finally, translation. The process by which the genetic messages carried by the RNA are decoded and used to build the proteins. So same here in the picture, first step is the DNA replication, where the replica or the identical copy of the DNA is formed when the cell is dividing. From here, transcription happens. So in transcription, the genetic message contained in the DNA are read and then copied. Finally, the translation happens. The genetic messages carried by the RNA are decoded here and they are used to build the proteins. Now let us discuss about transcription in detail. This is the first step in using the information stored in the DNA to produce the proteins in the transcription, using DNA as a template to make RNA. It is controlled by interactions of the promoter and enhancers. Several different types of rRNAs are produced, including mRNA, tRNA, and rRNA. Transcription involves four steps: initiation, elongation, termination, and processing. So let us discuss about transcription process in this picture. The first step, RNA polymerase attaches to the DNA at a sequence called the promoter. So first, the RNA polymerase has to come and attach to the DNA at specific site. Then what happens is, at that site, the DNA strand separates temporarily. So once the RNA polymerase is coming and binding to the DNA strand separate temporarily but not permanently. So there is temporarily separation of the DNA strands. Then this RNA polymerase adds the RNA nucleotides to the DNA template. So where the DNA has been separated, here the RNA nucleotides are being added. This RNA polymerase travels along with the template strand. So during elongation, the RNA polymerase walks along one strand of the DNA. Then finally, about termination, the transcription stops once the RNA polymerase reaches the terminator region. At this region, the RNA transcript and the RNA polymerase both fall off. And the RNA polymerase transiently associates with the termination factor to stop the transcription. So this was all about transcription process. Now coming to the translation. During translation, protein synthesis occurs. So the synthesis of proteins occurs at ribosomes, which are outside the nucleus and within the cytoplasm of the cells. mRNA connects with the ribosome and the amino acids attached to the transfer RNA are delivered one by one. Protein synthesis or translation takes place in three steps: initiation, elongation, and termination. During initiation, a ribosome, mRNA, and tRNA come together to form a complex. During elongation, amino acids are joined to the growing polypeptide chain. Finally, during termination, the protein has been synthesized and the ribosome, mRNA, tRNA complex dissociates. So here is a picture for better understanding of the process. So during initiation, the ribosome units, mRNA and tRNA come together to form a complex. Secondly, during elongation, the amino acids are joined to the growing polypeptide chain. Finally, during the termination, the protein has been synthesized. If you can see here, there's a stop codon synthesized here, which will stop the synthesis process. So the protein has been synthesized and the ribosome mRNA-tRNA complex gets dissociated. So this is how the translation process takes place. Now let us study about genetic code. The ribonucleotide sequence in the mRNA chain is like a coded sentence that specifies the order in which the amino acid residue should be joined to form a protein. Each word or codon in the mRNA sentence is a series of three ribonucleotides that code for a specific amino acid. For example, the series uracil-uracil-guanine on the mRNA chain is a codon directing the incorporation of the amino acid leucine into a growing protein chain. Now let us know about mutation. Any permanent change in the primary structure of the sequence of the nucleotide residues in the DNA is called mutation. Mutations might involve the switching of one base pair for another or the addition or deletion of the base pairs. Errors in the replication and exposure to the mutagens are the common causes of the mutations. Now let us know about recombinant DNA. Recombinant DNA contains two or more DNA segments not found together in nature. This is made by cutting a gene out of one organism and recombining it into the genetic machinery of another organism. The protein encoded by the inserted gene is then synthesized by the target organism. Insulin has been made by this way. This was all about the topic nucleic acids, and thank you.